So the first real solution to this problem, and one that is frequently still used today, is called Diffie-Hellman key exchange. It was first published by Whitfield Diffie and Martin Hellman in a very famous 1976 paper. It was actually discovered a few years earlier than that by Malcolm Williamson, who was working at the British government communication headquarters. This is the successor to Bletchley Park. It was kept classified, so Williamson didn't get credit for this, and it wasn't known that it had been discovered earlier there until quite recently. And this idea came from a paper that Diffie and Hellman published in 1976. I mentioned Shannon's paper as one of the three most important papers in cryptography. This is one of the other three. The third one, and I'm not trying to put these three in order, just chronologically, is the RSA paper that we'll talk about a little later. But this paper really introduced the idea of public key cryptography. It didn't provide a solution. It provided a solution to part of the problem. So they started with this introduction about we're on the brink of a revolution in cryptography and posed the question of can we build cryptographic tools that are the equivalent to a written signature? There are lots of other kinds of applications they talk about in the paper, as well as the idea of basing crypto systems on known hard problems or believed to be hard problems. The one solution that is in the paper that we're going to talk about today is this Diffie-Hellman key exchange protocol. And it's actually quite a simple protocol. It's still very widely used. And it allows two parties, without any prior agreement, to be able to establish a shared secret key.